Because we should go live on his Instagram.
We're about to sign some books, y'all. Jazz Journey.
Hey, oh, I look good on this lighting.
What time is it?
4:59.
Books on books on books on books on books.
Jesse, why are we doing this?
So I'm
right
the only person
now.
You could go live too, Megan, on my
Jesse is interior decorating right now when that is not the goal of what we're doing.
Oh, good.
Why?
And welcome
Jesse
to the book of the art show.
We right now, y'all, go to smileitbook.com because for the next, half hour?
45 minutes.
45 minutes. We're signing books if you go right now to smileitbook.com.
You pre-order a copy and you'll get it signed.
You'll
get
the books
that we're
signing.
So what we're saying is that we're doing this for an entire 45 minutes.
Yes. Yeah. You didn't get the memo?
Cool.
Wait, did you tell them that I'm hosting?
Oh, and our girl Gabby is hosting.
Wow, we didn't even properly introduce her.
I didn't even.
No, it's cool.
I did.
I wasn't going to charge y'all.
Are we on yet? Are we on?
Oh, no, we're not on yet.
We're not on yet.
All right,
Gabby's
going to we're going live on my Facebook and on Jake's Facebook.
All right, Gabby, I'm going to bring the mic.
But seriously, y'all, if y'all want a signed copy of our book, The Family Table, you have to go to Smollett Book.
Hi. Hello, viewers. I have half of you put too much rum in there. Now, I am Gabrielle City Bay, and I am here.
Woo! Standing ovation. Standing ovation.
I mean, I deserve, but I'm not here to be cheered. What I'm here for is to host this amazing virtual book signing for my friends, Jake and Jeremy and Jazz and Jesse Smollett, have all together written The Family Table.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen.
Look at them.
Look at it. Let's see the. Look at this. This is our cookbook.
So, here's what I want to say about this cookbook. There's some delicious recipes in there, and I think a lot of them I've tasted. No?
Yes, you have.
I sure do, because I invite myself to every single Christmas, Thanksgiving, dinner. I'm here.
You are.
Right?
You
here.
You
so I've had a lot.
And sometimes you help.
I've opened a can or two.
Yeah.
I've done that.
That's true.
And so we're here just so we can talk to their fans. We're going to answer a bunch of questions that you guys have already written in. And we're just going to be signing books for people who couldn't make it in.
Yes.
And so
having a ball.
Wait, a ball. Can people ask questions during this time? Can they still put in questions?
Can they? Yes. People can still, you can still click and type in some questions if you have anything on your mind that you want to get answered. Also,
you gotta go to smileybook.com.
Lucky fan is going to get an actual call from the four siblings.
And you,
I have to talk to people.
We're gonna call one of y'all, so y'all gotta go to smileybook.com. Right now, the next 30 minutes.
To do that.
In order to be entered for us to call you.
Stores now.
It comes out April 24th.
That's a week away. So, in order to order, you can go to smollettbooks.com.
Not books. Oh, just book.
It's smollettbook.com. And Smollett is spelled SMOLLETTBOOK.
Yes, let her do her job.
Why is she looking at me? Because she was looking at me. Were you not looking at me for confirmation? Right? Thank you.
I'm sweating. That is true.
The Gabby City Bay Show.
And then we're also going to play a small little game, like a Smollett game. It'll be fun.
A Smollett game.
Yeah, wow. You got it. See what I did there? So, first question. First question is from.
Wait, are we? I'm sorry.
We're supposed to be signing right now.
We're supposed to be signing these.
Yes, we are.
these
yeah.
pages.
Are y'all gonna like sign?
Are we signing?
Yeah. Yes, yeah. we are.
We're signing these. Oh, yeah. These one.
April, yeah. can you take my phone so the people can see? Yeah. Y'all go to smilerbook.com because you got 40 minutes to be entered. To order a book, you just order a book and you'll be ordering a signed copy.
Thank you. So they go, in order to ask the question or get the phone call possibly, they go to smilletbook.com and pre-order, right?
Okay. Ask your questions. If you have questions to ask and if you want to buy the book,
can we start signing?
You would go to smolletbook.com. SmolletBook.com. You know how to use a phone and a computer. So, question one. Is from Mark from Carson, California.
Carson!
It's Mark with a C, so I hope you're listening. Now, to each of you, use one word to describe the flavor of this book.
Ooh.
Mm. What's the flavor? Tell me what your flavor is.
Cajun? Creole? New Orleans? Home-style soul.
It's one
word.
One
word. Like,
let's get a semi-line going.
I said mine.
Don't sign a book. Cause this, wait, can we start with Jake and then just pass the book down so that all are signed?
Yeah.
That's
too much like writing.
Jake, you start there.
So yeah, wait. Scintillating.
Is someone in catch you?
Yeah, I'm answering Mark's question.
Okay.
Mark.
Oh, so your
answer is one word to describe the book or the rest of
the flavor of the cookbook.
The flavor.
Nomadic.
Jake.
I would say soul.
Soul.
Jake.
Oh.
I like Jam.
Soul.
Soul.
Sign.
Sign and talk, people. We gotta get these books to the people.
Okay, soul. Well, I hope that answered your question, Mark.
From Corson.
Ooh, ooh. This is our next question from Lakeisha. Yes, Lakeisha, she's from League City, y'all.
Yeah. We from where?
League City.
Oh, okay. Oh, I thought it was
League,
like
League. League, no, like a baseball league. Where is that, Lakeisha? I've never, okay, I assume it's a real place. What is your favorite dinner?
In the book or period?
Ooh, let's go for
Italian.
Period.
Italian. Lasagna.
Ooh, lasagna.
With bread and wine.
My favorite is the gumbo.
Oh, yeah.
We actually gave away our mother's gumbo recipe. Y'all, we shouldn't have done it. But
that was
in this book.
Controversial, too.
We argued about it. Because we were like, do we give them this? I mean, that's like really valuable, but we did. It's in the book.
Jenna gonna give y'all a whooping. Y'all give the recipe, and I will be around to film it. What's your favorite dinner, Jake?
I would have to say either the gumbo or the smothered chicken.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
I love the smoked chicken. And all the pastas.
Justifer?
Gumbo.
Gumbo. Well, I feel like the gumbos have it. Next question from Paula. She's from Indianapolis, Indiana.
Paula Abdul?
Could be. Honestly, anything is possible. This is the internet.
That's right.
So Paula asks, do you have any goat dishes in this book? If not, will you have any for your next book? Okay, goat? So I feel like Paula is probably either African or Jamaican or Caribbean. Paula, am I right? I think I'm right.
I don't think she is. Can she answer back?
Oh, hello?
I think so.
No. The judges are saying Paula can't answer back, but like as a goat eating African, uh-huh. I just feel like I know. Caribbean or African, because we be using goat. Now, any goat dishes?
But that, you know.
We don't have any goat dishes, but we got a lot of exotic dishes.
Yeah.
Like the, what, the North
African?
We got
the North African chicken stew.
Ooh, North African. Wow, so weird that you wouldn't make any West African food for me.
We have West African black eyed peas.
Oh.
She got delicious.
Yeah, don't try to.
We got a little bit of everything, y'all.
You're right.
You're trying to catch us out there.
Yeah. Because here's the thing. Okay, our mom's from New Orleans, you know, our dad is from New York, we were born in New York, in the Bay, in Santa Monica, like, we moved all over the country, and so we picked up different flavors from all different parts of the world.
Mm-hmm. And that's really the essence of the book, that we brought all of those flavors back to the family table.
All right, family table, I like it.
And that's why it's called the Family Table. Available April 24th. Everywhere where good books are sold.
Sold.
smolletbook.com and order a signed copy.
Again, go to smolletbook.com.
That's the wine books.
Our next question is from Africa Afini.
Now,
her name is Africa Afini. I love it. Africa with a K too. And she's from Randolph, Massachusetts. Shout out to Randolph, Massachusetts. What is your favorite novel?
Oh, Native Son.
Okay.
Yeah, how about
that? You do it.
Why is it? I like One Drop by Bliss Brilliant.
One Drop. Jake?
The Family Table.
Hey, you better.
Yeah, you better believe it. There's a lot of great writing in this book.
Yes.
Make sure you guys read
it. It's a cooking memoir. It really is about our family.
Go to smolletbook.com and get it. Jesse, do you have a favorite novel?
Smolletbook.
If you don't say, this is just my face.
This. Wow, wow. Oh, why would you why even say that? That, though? And I literally was going to say that. My favorite novel of all time was probably this heart-touching, funny, wonderful tale of this princess who would become queen. And it's this book,
Oscar nominated
it's
queen.
It's this book by this Oscar nominated multi-award winning artist. And it's
who knows
called,
how to work it more than
this
Beyonce
is just does. My face. Mm-hmm. Try not to stare by Gaboray. See that bit.
Insert the cover.
Available also where only good books are sold.
Mm-hmm. And if you want another
Fire.
Good book, go to smolletbook.com and get
right.
The Family Table.
Get it.
Get it.
You
look
can
the close
pre-order.
Up.
Get it.
If you pre-order the book right now, you'll get a signed copy.
Ooh, that's what one of these are. Yeah. You're doing signed copies right now. You can go
Jazz
and get it.
Jazz didn't just make
right
that
now.
Up either just to be nice. Like,
no,
this
true.
Really is.
We're signing it.
Signing is too bad.
Yeah, they are.
I gotta say, I like the red on black.
That is sexy.
Yeah,
I like the red on black.
Like Eddie Murphy Ross.
This is
like Chicago Bulls.
Let me see what they look like with all their signatures on it.
Oh, what's the finish? Oh,
wow!
You
didn't have
the
Jesse's.
Jess, excuse me? I did finish it.
Oh, but it's not how it looks in the other part.
Sometimes I get tired.
That's
one thing. Everything pointing that out.
Yeah.
I won't mention
for
that.
All of the world to see.
So our next question is from Ashley. She's from Springfield, Missouri. Her question is, what is your all-time favorite recipe from the book? Well, I guess we already covered that, right?
We did.
Yeah.
We did.
Gumbo. I mean, Ashley still deserves to get an answer, though.
Yeah, that was a word.
One of them for me is vanilla rose pound cake.
Oh, ooh. That sounds delicious.
So good.
And in addition to the gumbo, I personally love my Cornish hen.
Yes.
Oh, I love
classic.
Hen.
My Cornish hen, y'all. Yes. Y'all, my Cornish hen.
Okay.
I've been making them since I was like 8. Real talk, though.
No, really.
But she switched them up around age 20 with 20.
Yeah, like around 20, 20. 21 when I was in Austin.
You switched them up.
Literally, no joke. When I was in Austin, I started stuffing them.
Ooh. Okay, yeah. So I just want all of these, all the answers to these questions are also just for my birthday menu dinner.
Right. Yeah, it's coming up.
Right.
Y'all, also, I would just like to say that every once in a while, change your marker because it becomes flatter and then you want to point out.
But then it's nice, because it's then it's bold.
Mm-hmm.
You
want
to be bold. Okay, let me
change.
Our next
bold.
Question.
Be bold.
Jazz, you're falling behind.
Our next question is for Katrina. She's from Jackson, Tennessee. And the question is, what is your favorite childhood memory?
Oh.
Period?
Driving across
country. That's a really big question.
Driving across country. Or like driving up to the Bay, road trips.
Mine would have to be being woken up in the middle of the night going to Disneyland.
Oh my God, I have that same memory.
Oh yeah.
This is not therapy.
Oh, woken up like, clean your room.
Yeah.
Oh man.
That's why, because you should never go to bed with your room
dirty.
Exactly.
No, that would haunt your dreams, I guess.
Or the kitchen dirty. Everybody knows that.
Exactly. That's how you get roaches. Angelina from Forest Ant, Missouri, right?
Yeah.
What's all
you, y'all, Gary's trying to ask the questions.
What is your
favorite in different, oh, this is a weird What's you all favorite and different side dish?
Favorite and different?
Ooh, side dish.
I like the garlic mushroom quinoa.
There is a whole chapter
on side dishes.
On side dishes.
There's side dishes.
Oh, crab. The crab fried rice. The potato crab broth. Wait, we have to show y'all so many recipes.
The crab fried rice. The potato gratin with crab in it.
I would just like to say,
make a side dish.
Listen.
Don't be one.
Boom.
Let us know.
My doom potato salad, not Karen's potato salad.
Who's Karen? So, Logan from Federal Way, Washington asks, what's the worst dish you've had from one of your siblings? Ooh,
Jojo!
Have you ever told Jojo. Them, and how did you fake like it?
We don't fake it!
Oh, no.
We don't fake it!
Why don't you care about your brother's siblings?
No, but that's just you don't betray your taste buds like that.
What did Jojo make?
Well, to me, it was some jockey cake, but...
Jockey,
I love your ham, Jockey.
I love your ham, Jockey.
Don't you let us have
to ever second guess yourself, boy.
Seriously.
Jockey made a ham.
He has stepped it up and been
honey
so
Jack.
Aggressive
lately.
Okay.
Jack
I'm not mad at that, though.
It was incredible. And Jack didn't like it. She came out on it.
Wow.
She really did.
All right.
We're all excited with this book.
Well, then, what did Jojo make these guys in a tree with?
Jojo burnt like 3 racks of ribs once.
Honey.
Oh, I took a picture of it.
And brought them in.
Ooh, is it fair to say that Jojo's the worst cook in the family?
This is what's not going to happen, though. We're not going to trash our oldest brother while he's not here to defend himself. Or our youngest brother while they're not here to defend themselves.
Well, Jockey,
listen, Sally, Jesse, Raphael.
No!
You're not about to try.
No, this is Logan. Logan did this.
Logan.
What you will not do, Logan, is tear this family apart. Now, Vanita from Los Angeles, California.
Okay, right here, down the street.
Will your mother's grapefruit drink be in the woods? Does she know y'all?
Will her what?
Your mother's grapefruit drink be in the
woods? Wait, what's her name?
Her name is Vanita. V-E-N-I-T-A. Vanita,
wait, what grapefruit drink? The grapefruit drink we made at the ceremony event?
No. Probably not.
The grapefruit cocktail. Grapefruit cocktail?
Yeah.
Vanita, who even knows?
Vanita.
Who even knows grapefruit cocktail?
Vanita. How do you know us?
Grapefruit spritzer in the drink.
Our mom growing up would use grapefruit. She like how some people think Robitussin cures everything. Everything is cured with grapefruit juice.
Yeah.
Like everything. Growing up we didn't really drink orange juice. We drank grapefruit juice. Mommy would do this liver flush with like grapefruit juice and garlic and olive oil, right?
Yeah.
Remember what we used to have to like make it?
Yeah.
Disgusting, but it worked.
Okay.
It's healthy.
We're on the last book.
It's okay. Do you guys do this one?
No, I'm saying that's great.
They did it. And look, they finished. That's the last signature.
Well, that's the last book.
All of these books you can get. Go to smallactbook.com to pre-order your book and maybe get one that's signed. Get it.
It was so great to see y'all.
And you know we have a bunch. These are not all the signed copies. They're not a limited amount. Whoever pre-orders a book on smallactbook.com will get a signed copy. We'll have to sign more.
Every
Jazz is killing this. Jazz needs to be up on HSN. Being like, ooh, this book, look how it's so delicious. It's so delicious.
Don't bend the pages. Come on. Now
that's true. That's somebody's book. Somebody purchased that book.
Yeah, that's somebody's book. Okay.
We actually had more books, but Jake took them. Was giving them away.
Wow.
To,
yeah.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.
I was like, hey, you want a book? You want one of my books?
No, you got it.
Hey, you want one of my books? I got a book. I want a couple of books. Hey, you want a book? I will give you a book.
That's not how it works. So S. Electra from Riverdale, Georgia. Shout out to Georgia.
Georgia.
I would love to know when the passion of cooking started for you. Jake, specifically for Jake, it would be awesome to make a song with Jesse Jazz, Jesse Journey Jazz.
What?
All right, she's excited. What keeps you guys motivated in your careers? So I guess question one is, when did the passion for cooking start?
What's this young woman's name?
Her name is S. Electra.
Oh, S. Electra. Oh, S. Period. Electra.
Yeah, S. Yeah.
Got it.
We all started cooking super early.
Really young.
Because there's a lot of us.
So survival.
I started cooking around 6. You were like 6.
Yeah.
4.
I was 7 because I'm one of the oldest, so they waited a little longer. So I was 7.
Justin?
I was late.
All my life I had to cook. We started getting early, I don't remember.
It also was it started because of our mom is like a dynamic cook in the kitchen. I mean, everything is from scratch, fresh.
Bread.
So we wanted to cook because she made it fun. Like, so it turns into a passion at an early age because it was like, we want to get in the kitchen with our mom, you know? And she's, it's a fun event.
Aww.
So.
And before we were cooking on our own, we were on the counter next to her while she was cooking. Like, she'd sit us on the counter and...
Before we were cooking on our own, our canceled show by ABC in the 94-95 season.
So I let them know it was canceled after
they
a year.
Know.
Don't say the year. Don't ever say the 94-95.
They know.
Well, next question.
Okay. What keeps you guys motivated in your careers, though? Y'all don't know no different.
Yeah. I think the motivation comes from the love of it. You know, it's like I could literally never imagine doing anything other than what I do.
Right.
And I'm blessed to be able to make a living doing what I love.
Right.
And that's the thing about it, like growing up, arts for us, it wasn't like a job, it was like a passion and a hobby. Like mommy would sing Fraulein Maria and have the Sound of Music on all the time, and we would sing songs and make up plays, and anytime she wanted a present for Mother's Day or for her birthday, we had to do a concert. So like the arts in our home was the nucleus of our home, you know? So I think that's why it's just so natural for us to continue it on, because we love it.
That is adorable. Y'all like the Jacksons.
Love it. That's amazing.
I mean, here's an interesting question from Irisha. Or Irisha, maybe, from Portland, Oregon.
Portland?
How was it growing up with so many siblings? Did you ever feel like you couldn't be an individual?
No, because we were actually really made to be our own selves. We were told at an early age, like, go play by yourself. Go be by yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, so there was always searching for who you are since we were, you know, young. I can't imagine like not having them around.
No. Scandal!
You know what?
Ask yourself,
what is
shame?
No,
it's amazing. Absolutely amazing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And still, like, to have 5 siblings is incredible. Yeah, I mean, it's close to... We're
all each other's best friends, which is really sweet. Every time it's someone's birthday, they always post, this is my best friend, one of my 5 best friends. It's really cute. I think it's weird, but now I get it. It's really sweet. Okay, Jabari from Westbury, New York. Are you
guys... Is that Jabari?
Do we know him?
Yes.
Jabari. He's from Westbury.
Yes.
Hey Jabari.
Make sure to go to smalletbook.com, by the way. Pre-order your book, The Family Table.
Nice.
You pre-order it and you get a signed copy.
Absolutely. You'll get it right in your mailbox Jabari wants to know if y'all gonna have a cooking workshop in New York.
We are. Yeah.
Oh, really? Oh, where? We have a cooking workshop. You're just gonna have a cooking event?
Yes.
Where and when?
We are gonna have the
Barnes and Noble.
You're gonna be cooking at Barnes and Noble.
Oh, we're cooking like on the.
Oh, yeah, on the Today Show. Yeah, we're cooking on the Today Show. No, Mitchell.
The
24th.
Okay.
April 25th.
April 25th.
The morning.
5.
The Today Show. They will be cooking and probably handing out plates.
Well, wait now.
She said mine.
Okay. Next question. These don't have names to them. Wait, hold on.
But we are going to be Barnes & Noble in Tribeca. Yes. We can't start telling people about that. 6 p.m. Yeah. April 24th in Tribeca, New York. The Barnes & Noble there will be doing
books signings. Oh. And we'll be at the LA Times Book Fair.
Yeah.
Oh, can they get information about all of your dates by going to smollettbook.com?
No.
Oh, well.
They can be ordered the book.
Well, who the hell is our webmaster? Why?
Is there a list of where they, is there any place they can go for a list of drugs?
We'll post it.
They'll post.
Follow us on social media.
Follow all of them on social media.
For updates.
Is it all just your names?
Yeah.
So, Jake Smollett, Journey Smollett Bell.
Well, on Instagram.
On Instagram it's Journey Bell. On Twitter it's Journey Smollett.
Yeah.
On Twitter it's Journey Smollett. On
Instagram it's
Journey Bell.
I'm Jazz Smollett Warwell.
Spell
Warwell. Find me through them.
See who they tag.
WARWELL on Instagram.
And
on Twitter is Jazz Smollett.
Yeah. And Jussie Smollett.
I am Jussie Smollett on Instagram and on Twitter. I am Jussie Forahu Smollett Ibone Several.
This is new. Lives don't. He's a middle child who needs a lot of attention.
Journey's a middle child too.
Well,
I don't need that. No, it kept changing though, realistically.
Yeah, that's the thing.
It kept changing.
Middle child.
Yeah.
I mean, there's six of you, so.
Well, because they kept. They
like
kept
Jazz changing. Was a middle child for a while, because and she was not only the middle child, but the only girl.
Oh, okay. That was different. 6 years.
And then, Journey
Journey's
came.
Next.
And Jazz and I.
And then we were in the middle.
Right.
And then Jake came.
Okay, more questions, Steve?
Life.
Okay. I'm calling this right now, so I
work this out after Jockey came.
Here's a point.
It's me and Journey. But no, if you really think about it, it's like.
But go to smollettbook.com.
Here's a point.
Smollettbook.com, you guys can get a signed copy of the book if you order it at smollettbook.com.
Ask questions. Here's a great question. Will you do a second season of Smollett Eats?
Our schedule, everybody, we can't, I try to get everybody together for a Christmas dinner. Exactly. And to get everyone on time,
well,
there at the same time, is impossible.
It's hard.
You didn't show up for Easter at my house.
Uh-oh.
And neither did you. Next question.
Therapy session is about to start. Stuff.
Has there ever been a dish that either of you have made that the rest of the family asked you to never, ever make again?
Never for me. How about you guys?
Oh, wow, Jake. The confidence that you exhibited.
Never for me.
Hmm. All right, this is Jake.
Not for Jake.
Jake is pretty solid. Jake last night came down for Jess's birthday.
Never.
Happy birthday, Jake!
Yourself.
Mm-hmm. Little known facts. Okay, wait, what spices you
that's
say?
That's what led to the cookbook. Gabby, can I have some of
Yeah. Yeah. What was the question? The question is, outside of
coffee, what's up? Are on my coffee table.
Oh, I thought that was...
I'm doing wonderful. I'm with my whole family.
Hey, Elizabeth.
Well, not the whole family. A little bit of the family.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth.
How you doing, girl?
I'm good.
Did you pre-order this book?
Just how is she being able to call in if she didn't pre-order?
I'm just making sure there wasn't a mistake.
Jazz is selling
it. Jazz is going to sell this book.
Do you have a question, Elizabeth, from Chicago? International? Any place out of the country?
I love Louise. I love There's a really small town right outside of Belgium named Bruges. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but that's how I think it's pronounced. And it was amazing for, I mean, like, the restaurants and the cuisine was incredible.
I think it is Bruges.
Okay. So far, Johannesburg and Kingston, Jamaica.
For more reasons than one.
We don't know. They also were really good at Bob Marley out there.
I need some.
We went to the Bob Marley Museum.
Of course.
Okay. We stayed happy all day long. Nobody can tell us what to do. Living in the life of love.
Next question, yes. Gabby.
Here's a good, okay, you have to impress someone. Okay, you can put like the Obamas.
Is that a question or your question?
No, this is, I'm just like putting flavor on it. So the Obamas are coming over for dinner and you really, really want to impress them. What is the one dish that each of you would make? And it's got, it can't be the same goddamn thing.
Okay.
You can all say gumbo. What's the thing that you want to make that wins them over?
I'm making flourless chocolate cake. The only reason it's flourless, not because of anyone being gluten free. Or healthy.
But it's
flourless because it makes, it's flourless because it makes it more chocolatey. Mm-hmm. It's rich.
It's so good, too.
All my chocoholics out there.
Yes.
This flourless chocolate cake is for you.
That's
and is it in the book? Is there
it's in the book.
Good. So go to smollettbook.com and you can get a signed copy of the book. And also this flourless chocolate cake for you. Apparently it's
fine. And it's really actually quick to make.
Ooh.
It's good.
Truffle.
Then you dust it with some confectioner sugar and you put a little edible flour decoration. And your mamas would be like, wow.
Journey, what's your wild dish?
So I can't say my Cornish hens.
That's kind of my go-to.
That's your go-to. That's kind of my
famous Cornish hens that you now put stuffing into.
I mean, your mac and cheese.
My mac and cheese.
Her collard greens.
Her mac and cheese.
Those collard greens. My collard greens are so good.
And your potato salad, your Cornish game tins with your potato salad.
And my collard greens and my mac
and cheese. Yeah, that's a perfect dish. That's
she's
perfect
trying
plate.
To make the entire meal.
Okay, okay, cool.
Yeah, catered by Journey.
No.
Justin, what's your wow? What's
let
your
Jake
wow?
Go next. I'm trying to look because I forgot that it had to be something specific.
Jake, what's your wow dish?
It would have to be the fried lobster pasta.
Yes!
With the vodka sauce. Ooh. A rustic vodka sauce.
Delicious.
He makes a mean vodka sauce.
Oh my gosh,
what's so the vodka sauce for my birthday yesterday on the
it was pasta? It was a children's vodka-less vodka sauce. I didn't want to take the chance to go here.
This game's not good.
Gee, when it cooks off.
I know, it cooks off.
I appreciate it. I appreciate it.
Hunter's one. I'm out.
Yeah, you appreciate it. Mine is three, so vodka is not.
I don't have her sweet.
She's good.
You know, I would probably make them some delicious fish curry soup.
Ooh.
Yeah, nice starter.
That's the wow.
Yeah, that's the
wow. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I actually kind of hate my head that did sound
they've done all of the meals. They got the dessert, they got the entree, and everything. Yeah. Jake, what did you make?
Did you guys go to smallest.com
yet? Oh! My pizza.
Wait.
Everything.
Did you make a bomb pizza?
Bomb pizza.
Wait. Did you go to smollettbook.com yet and pre-order this book so you could get a signed copy?
I did. We went.
By all four of us. A signed copy. Yeah. Especially if you're not going to be able to come to that book event in New York at Barnes & Noble. You get your pre-order and you can have exactly from the comfort of your home what those people have coming to this event. Yeah.
Come on, comfort of your own.
Sure. Yes.
For all you shut-ins.
HSN.
Get it.
So
okay, so now I'm going to ask 22 questions in 2 minutes, and then we can say our goodbyes.
Okay.
So I'm going to ask each of you down the line.
You
okay?
Sure it's not going to take 22 minutes?
That depends on y'all.
Okay. Wait, so what is this?
This is 22 questions in 2 minutes. I'm going to go down the line and then, like, back, okay?
So each question,
questions.
We all have to answer?
We all answer each question.
Well,
we have to each answer.
Short. Yeah,
I think
we'll try to do it in 22 minutes. Can somebody start a timer and see how we do
this?
Is
your all professional? You got it all laminated and everything? And look at the nice design. Goodness. Oprah Winfrey.
All right, 22 questions in 2 minutes. Where were you born?
Queens, New York.
Who would you want to play
with? Wait, we got to keep going.
Yeah,
each person.
I'm going to ask each of you a question.
Oh, we all get a question.
But somebody gets a better No.
No, you're not. True. Like, we'll just go. No, because we're never going to get you 22 questions.
Yeah, it's not the matter. Let's do everybody to answer.
Johnny, no!
You're getting loud.
She's taking her ears off.
You're getting loud.
That's gasoline.
You're getting loud, and I'm going to have to come through. Okay?
Denzel Washington.
Not for you. These
are also questions and answers.
What am I saying?
But we're not going to go with it.
Look, okay, here's how we'll do. Jake is number one. Question one. Question two. Question three.
Let's
move
to the answer.
But what if we promise that we will answer really quickly?
Well, probably
we
will answer so fast.
No, wait.
Okay, so let's go. Where are you all born? Jake, Jeremy, Jasmine.
No, that's so boring. I like her method.
All right, whatever.
An answer. See, it's people who are like random old.
See, that's just, so say that. If it was your Uber driver, say it was your Uber driver.
Okay. Go to Smollett Bookshop. Order a signed copy.
For Jazz's answer. I don't have one.
Ooh,
our dad didn't have one. None of the boys in the
Jake Shakanaka.
No, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't.
He's not. He always adds a middle name. He does not have a middle name.
This is like the biggest scandal that has rocked our friendship since your goddamn ID. Because you've been calling yourself.
Just get out. Keep it going.
Wow.
What was it?
Just keep it going. Taking time for me.
say stuff about themselves, and it's like really just.
It's a compliment.
So it's like, you know, I'm just constantly doing things for other people. Oh,
no. The worst thing about myself, I don't know.
Worst habit. Not worst thing about yourself.
Oh, the worst habit. The worst habit. I don't think any one of my habits are worse.
Okay, next question.
I think that they're all right.
Jake, what was the last gift you gave?
I don't give gifts.
He gave you all the gift of the
salad. No, that's a gift. You cooked that entire meal for my birthday yesterday.
I was going to say, Jake made an entire spread of grilled shrimp, grilled salmon on
grilled
plate.
Asparagus, grilled steak.
He doesn't give gifts with a pesto sauce, chopped pasta with a red sauce,
with some Parmesan sprinkled on it.
Y'all, Jerry has something prophetic
to say. Jake gives the gift of his time,
which is more valuable than anything you can buy.
Except for, you can give this as a gift.
I love y'all.
The family table.
I love you.
The family table is a great gift, and it's a gift that keeps on giving.
Go to smallbookbook.com,
order a signed copy for your friends and family. Or your spouse.
Why the hell are we on channel that we are? We should be on HSN. Why are we on freaking Facebook.com?
No, we're on
Journey.
What the hell are we doing?
What was the last album you bought or streamed?
Jussie's Summer Music.
You want to give a little performance and show the crowd what the album is like?
Will you whistle along?
Okay.
Next question. If he performs, I will.
Next question.
For Jack. What is your favorite thing to cook?
For me?
Yes, and we're all on everybody's last question.
Baking.
I also want to go to Kenya.
I was going
to
say
Kenya. And I want to go to Ghana.
I
Books that we're about to sign. We're about to go live and sign books for people who pre-order them at smolletbook.com.
All right, y'all, go to smolletbook.com because right now, me and my siblings, hey y'all, Jesse's trying to decorate. We're signing books, and if you go to smolletbook.com, you can just buy a signed copy right now.
You know, I'm just constantly doing this for other people.
No. The worst thing about myself, I don't know.
Worst habit.
Oh, the worst habit. The worst habit. The worst habit. I don't think any one of my habits are worse.
Okay, next question.
I think that they're all right.
Jake, what was the last gift you gave?
Last gift.
That's a gift. You cooked that entire meal for my birthday yesterday.
I was going to say, Jake made an entire spread of grilled shrimp, grilled salmon on
grilled asparagus, grilled steak.
He doesn't give gifts.
No,
he doesn't give gifts.
No pasta with a pesto sauce. Bow tie pasta with a red sauce with some Parmesan sprinkled on it.
Y'all, Jordy has something prophetic
to say. Jake gives the gift of his time,
which is more valuable than anything you can buy.
Except for,
you can give this as a gift.
I love y'all.
The family table.
I love you.
The family table is a great gift, and it's a gift that keeps on giving.
Go to smolletbook.com
or a signed copy for your friends and family.
Why the hell are we on this channel that we're on? We should be on HSN. Why are we on freaking Facebook.com?
No, we're on
Journey.
What the hell are we doing?
What was the last album we bought or streamed?
Yes!
You want to give a little performance and show the crowd what the album is like?
Will you whistle along?
Okay. Next question.
If he performs, I will.
Next question.
For Jack. Yes. What is your favorite thing to cook?
Me?
Yes, and we're all on everybody's last question.
Baking.
Praise God.
Baking anything. A cake.
Anything.
And beans. I like to bake beans.
Bean queen.
You know what? I'm going to start baking some desserts out of beans. Bean paste, you know, like a...
Oh, yeah.
You can do that with red beans. You can do that with red beans.
Cool.
Yeah. Like a red bean paste?
No.
Yeah.
So
but funny. I love baking the vanilla rose pound cake and the chocolate cake and donuts, cookies. There's ice cream from scratch, all kinds of stuff.
All of it, the family table. Now on smolletbook.com. Jesse.
Should we maybe bring the kids so we look like a wholesome family?
Next question.
What cause is dear to your heart?
Oh. The cause for children, the cause for education, the cause against, to fight HIV/AIDS.
Is there a cause in particular that you can send people to the website for?
Sure, you can go to blackaids.org, you can go to the Lujan Foundation, you can go to the Trayvon Martin Foundation.org, you can go to sanctcova.org, yes, yes.
You
can
go to Children's Defense Fund?
That's right.
Children's Defense Fund.
Is it .com?
.org.
Yeah. For Jake, name anything on your bucket list.
Skydiving.
Wow. Don't do it.
No.
It used to be on my
list. Once you hit 30, you won't care.
There's indoor.
Well, I ain't 30 yet.
You should do half life indoor skydiving. And
yeah, just
you're
do
less
that.
Likely to die.
Yeah, I'm good with the fake shit. I want the real thing.
All right.
Well,
okay. And Jeremy is the last question.
And we're all going to ask it, answer it.
22 questions in obviously 25 minutes. Where do you want to go that you've never been?
Ooh.
I'm sure everyone is there, but Journey first.
I really want to go to Egypt. Never been. There's a lot of places, but that's the one at the top of my bucket list.
Pretty good. Jazz?
This is so long.
Oh my god.
The world is so big.
Oh,
Africa,
I really want to go to India, though. I really do.
Jake? Where we want to go? Morocco.
Yeah.
want to.
Erica's just popping.
I want to go to Nigeria. Yes. Senegal.
Yeah, I really
want to
go.
I also
want to
go to Kenya really bad.
I was
going to
say Kenya.
And I want to go to Ghana.
Y'all, we got
to go to Ghana.
Okay, so
that's where we're from.
That's where we're from. We found out. I'm from Brooklyn, but I'm Senegalese.
I'll take
all of us. You realize all the years we've been friends now, you've yet to make me Senegalese food.
Excuse me.
You've been promising all these years.
Excuse me. I took you to a Senegalese restaurant in Chicago.
And yes, it's true. I do know how to make gourmet French fries. Yes, I do. Really make them for me. Nah, motherfucker, I took you to McDonald's. It's not the same thing.
Oh, come on!
Make me some Senegalese food. Take down the man that's trying to take you down. So just remember.
You guys, remember, you guys. And remember, go to